Hello sustainable growers. In this video, we will see the second part of the interview we had with Mr. Peng, where he's going to explain us what are the best vegetables to grow in commercial aquaponics. I hope you're going to enjoy this video, but just before, please subscribe to the channel, and if you haven't done it yet, download your free gift from the description of the video. Okay, Mr. Peng, so what is for you the best vegetables or the easiest one to grow in aquaponics where you see a big potential?
Okay. Normally, people tend to grow leafy vegetables first.
Yes.
Which is a good idea.
Yeah.
When you just start up, you grow, you know, small herbs.
Yes.
Lettuce, that kind of leafy vegetables is good for your bacteria. You know, that kind of thing. Easy to grow.
Yes.
And they grow fast. Gradually, if you are you know, getting more and more knowledge and skill,
yeah,
you can, you know, get into fruit vegetables.
Yes. Yes. Such as tomatoes.
Yeah, tomatoes, you know, cucumber, chili, that kind of thing. Yeah. And if you have enough space, you grow root vegetables also. You can also do that.
But you got some challenge in there with the media, no?
Yes, yes. If you have a good media, bit loose, then you can grow lots of different root vegetables. Yeah. Even carrots, you know.
Carrots, yeah. Maybe. I tried carrots many times in my setup. Mm. I got a very porous media, and the carrots are always, they got this shape that is, you can't work with it, you know. Then if you want to peel it, you will spend ages.
The reason for that is the media. If the media is porous, but they are not very fluid,
yes, yeah,
actually, that would be a problem. You need a media very fluid with water fill up, then they kind of semi-floating in the water. Then the vegetable will have a free space to expand.
Exactly. Yeah. Otherwise, they can't move and they get those shapes between
shapes,
the media, which is sometimes very funny.
Yes. Yes.
So, okay, the roots, they are a bit challenging, but you say that you are able to grow potatoes and carrots.
Yams.
Yams.
Yeah, but not potatoes.
Potatoes.
Chinese yams. They're supposed to grow more than, you know, 50 centimeters long.
Wow.
Yeah, it's supposed to be that. So, because for the marketing purpose, actually, you don't have to do that. You make them grow multiple tubes.
Okay.
So each tube is smaller, but they grow a lump of. So this is still doable. It's a very interesting.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm looking forward for the result.
Well, you planted some?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Okay. When is your harvest?
It requires the entire circle of season.
Oh, okay. So full year?
Yeah, full year. Wow. At least 8 months.
Okay, we'll see. We're going to watch your videos.
Yeah, come back. Yeah,
okay, and in terms of, I am the same. I think when you start a setup, it's good to start with leafy veggies that don't require too complex, too much nitrogen and not too complex.
Mm.
And then you can go for tomatoes, those kind of things that are a bit more demanding.
Yes.
Sometimes I found that if you try chili or other kind of fruits, they may require some minerals that are maybe not in good quantity in your grow bed.
Yeah.
And sometimes they grow a little bit and then they just die when you lose them, right?
Yeah.
Did you find it as well?
Yes. If you don't have any sufficient minerals to sustain the fruit, the flower, then the yield is very disappointing. So you need to watch out and do a bit of research.
Yeah, exactly.
That kind of thing is kind of very knowledge intensive.
Yes. Yeah.
You it's not your normal you know, peasant job. You do need to get into it and get online and do your research.
Yeah.
Take pictures, join the groups, and you know, find out what's going on and how to deal with it. And it won't take too long. It's very interesting. By the time your efforts yield results, it's the happiest moment of your life.
Yeah, it's becoming very specific then when you grow, when you go into this field. Because it's very easy to build a setup, I mean, to put a setup in place and to grow a bit of leafy veggies.
Yes.
It's easy for anyone.
Yes, yes.
But then going to specific fruits and having a good yield.
I need a bit of skill.
It's another story, right?
Yes,
you need a bit more experience.
Yes.
Because if you look at hydroponics, they just put the nutrient into the water that are specifically adapted to one species of veggies.
Yes, yes.
But here in aquaponics, we try to grow different spaces with the same water.
Yeah.
So you can't have the water specifically good for one species, otherwise it's not going to be good for the others.
No.
So we try to have a range where everyone is happy.
Yes, yes, yes.
Right?
A compromise.
Yeah, a compromise. That's the word, exactly. We try to compromise.
Yes, yes.
So that's a bit the big difference with hydroponics, I would say.
Yes. Oh, you mentioned the hydroponics, so I want to say a few words to beginners.
Yeah.
If you have a limited space, and you do not have enough experience in dealing with fish, you might as well start with a small hydroponic system and get yourself used to the procedures, the knowledge, that kind of thing. Then you have enough confidence that you can convert your hydroponic system to aquaponics, give you more pleasure.
With the difference that in hydroponics we don't play with bacteria, we don't work with bacteria.
No.
So it makes a big difference.
Yeah. You need to learn more. Yeah.
Yeah. But still, yeah, it's
a starting point.
Yeah, exactly.
It give you a bit of, stimulate your interest.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's the first step. Okay. And what about beans? Do you grow?
Oh yes, yes, yeah. You can grow beans.
Yeah.
And I'm going to tell you. The advantages of aquaponics over hydroponics.
Okay.
In a grow media environment, you can grow beans and fairly fantastic results from aquaponics with good amount of fish. The thing is this, the water is still relatively pristine.
Yes.
But you still can grow heavy crop, but not in hydroponics. Hydroponics, if you want to grow proper beans in hydroponics, the reading of parts per million requires a fairly high range, up to 1,000 to sustain beans. You check on the material, they will tell you. You have a list online, you tell you want to grow beans, the per parts per million can be over 1,000
of what specific element
for the solution.
They give
you
the mix, you mean?
They sell the mixed ones. You need to add until you check the solution,
it's
the concentration
with lots of chemicals,
then you find out it's over that, then you can grow. But that kind of concentration will not happen in aquaponic system. If it does, the fish will suffer. So this is very interesting. I find aquaponics in this aspect is far more healthier and natural.
So that's always I mean, I think it's completely magic to close the loop and to work with a full cycle and to work
of
with
life,
nature. It's just
magic.
It's magic. I think as well.
Yes.
Okay. So we went. Are you growing some flowers as well? Ornamental flowers?
I grow flowers. It's called lily.
Lilies.
Lily. But we grow lily for two reasons. One, for the flowers, pretty flowers.
Yeah.
Then for the tube. The tube is edible.
Right.
A type of protein.
So when you talk about lilies, are you talking about the aquatic lilies or the?
No.
Okay.
Oh,
you eat the tubes and.
Yes.
Wow. Okay, I didn't even know that.
It's a fantastic fruit. Yeah.
Okay. And so, have you tried to evaluate your production during the year, like in terms of kilos or?
Yeah. You can do it. Once you set up a particular crop.
Yeah.
Because when you set up the crop, you need to figure out how many weeks does it require to mature.
Yeah.
So you allocate a certain amount of growing space for the entire circle to run, you know, continuously.
Mm-hmm.
So you can figure out how much money you can make in this kind of, you know, circulation. Yes,
yeah.
I'll give you an example. So for instance, we grow garlic chives.
Yeah,
garlic chives is a type of vegetable for Chinese dumplings, so they need quite a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
Every 4 weeks, you can cut once. Therefore, you figure out, you see, the you need about four, at least four lots to have the full production
yes.
running. So you, every time you cut it and sell it, you know, okay, for the four lots, every week you can make that much money.
Ah, yeah, yeah. So you know exactly, I mean, approximately for each species
yes.
of vegetables, what you will produce
yes,
if you were converting your whole
true,
setup.
True. All
right.
And with the growth of the crop, because over winter, you normally you don't cut it, you let it regenerate,
yes,
become more dense, you know. So next year you can cut a bit more. So anyway, this is requires a bit more skills for management.
Okay.
This
yeah.
is my experience.
Yeah.
Unless you just don't really care, you know, just
yes. Yeah,
go with the flow.
Fun,
yeah,
yeah,
for fun. If you want to run you know, something can really produce something and at least pays for itself. Then you need to be a bit more management conscious.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I don't know if you have done the studies so far, but
mm-hmm.
what kind of crop would you grow now if you wanted to produce the more possible? Like,
oh, okay.
What would be the maximum production you could have
mm-hmm.
with what kind of crop?
Okay. So far, I realized that in my particular situation,
yeah.
leafy vegetables are the easiest variety to make money quickly.
Okay.
The next thing is chili. Chili and bean, because they continuously
produce. Ah,
yeah.
Yeah.
Tomato is another case, depends on the variety. Some variety will have continuous growth, but they occupy too much space. Okay.
They take a lot of light.
Yeah. And the next thing would be one type of cucumber.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Do you produce cucumber?
Yeah, cucumber. This is a Chinese variety. It does not grow very big. It only grows that big, but very flavorsome.
Ah.
Strong,
okay.
with very strong aroma.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So many people just eat it for raw, eating raw. They don't cook it. So and it grows so many of them. One single crop, if you take care of the crop properly, I calculated roughly one single crop over one season, more than 200 of them.
Wow! And what is the weight? Like 200 grams.
200. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Wow,
that's amazing, man! Every day you come in, you find new cucumbers come out. So this variety is amazing. It's very suitable for that kind of system.
Yeah.
Apparently, you know, constant supply of water, nutrients, sunlight, heat.
Yes, mm-hmm. I understand. So I imagine you also went. You found maybe some species that you couldn't really grow in aquaponics because they had some specific requirements
mm-hmm.
that we couldn't meet.
Mm-hmm.
I found the same thing. Sometimes you got some vegetables,
mm-hmm.
probably they don't like moisture,
no.
or maybe
yeah.
they got specific requirements in terms of pH that
cover, yes.
and you can't really grow them.
No.
But maybe in another system, someone has got another system, it will maybe grow because every system is completely different.
A bit specific,
yeah.
yes.
So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And another question I really wanted to ask you because I find it's a big challenge for me and for a lot of people that
mm.
I know,
mm.
how do you fight or not fight, but how do you deal with pests like insects?
Oh yes, it's kind of nuisance. The common damage done by insects is.
If you are watching this video on YouTube, you will see that on the description of the video just below, you will have access to some free gifts. first you have access to a six-step process to be able to build your own aquaponics system in good conditions. I developed this six-step process because I found that too many beginners are basically starting aquaponics with a wrong design. So if you want to build your own aquaponics setup, please just follow this six-step process. It's completely free, right? I redesigned it to help you to build your setup in good conditions and therefore to succeed in aquaponics. The second gift is for people who already have aquaponics. A very common problem we have in aquaponics is that we got the leaves of the vegetables that are turning yellow. And the reason why is because basically in aquaponics we sometimes need to add some minerals, otherwise the vegetables have some deficiencies. So if you have this problem, I made a special video about it as well, and you can have access to it in the description of the video. It's the free bonus video. If you are very interested into aquaponics, you can also have access to a webinar, a free webinar specific to aquaponics. I deliver a lot of information. Finally, you are probably aware that I wrote a digital aquaponics manual called The Art of Aquaponics, and you can have access to a free excerpt of this aquaponics manual where I add a lot of value and I give you a lot of my knowledge about aquaponics. So don't forget that you can have access to those four gifts on the description of the video, and I'm sure they're going to help you to develop your aquaponics setup and to produce your own sustainable and healthy food in good conditions. Bye bye. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.